decorate my room in real life. You know, my human-sized room. But I'm going to use my mini room to test out a few design ideas. I made a miniature representation of my actual room in our 14 Quick Crafts video. Right now, it's a little untidy. Wow, talk about art imitating life. So a lot of these pieces will stay, but we're just gonna spruce it up a little bit to give it a fresh look. First, let's clear out the clutter. We cleared out the room without destroying it too much. I think I want to move the bed to that wall, but I glued that shelf in place. So, but I'm gonna try anyway. Oh, look at that. I didn't glue it down that good. Looks like only one side is really glued into place. Oops, sorry. So now we just need to reach over there and get it. Oh, I didn't even use glue. I used putty. Even better. Now we can move the shelf to this wall. Now we can put the bed on the back wall. I'm probably going to keep the TV right there. In real life, I probably would have moved it to this wall, but this wall doesn't exist, so we're going to keep it there. I'm going to use poster putty to stop the items from moving around too much. Place it underneath, then push it in place. I am always moving my rooms around, so it's important for me to make sure they don't wiggle around. Let's place the mattress pad back on the bed. I'm going to use a solid white comforter this time. Bring in some white pillows. I like lots of pillows, so I'm going to go a little crazy here. Let's add some fuzzy pillows. I really love this salmony color and brown right now, so I cut a rectangle to fold and lay at the bottom of the bed. I like a lot of blankets, but they all can't go on the bed, so I take three wooden dowels, cut one into 2.5-inch pieces. I'm using floral wire cutters to cut the wooden dowels, glue them onto the other two wooden dowels. Before we do that, let's file those edges. I really don't want any splinters. Then I glued them right on top with a hot glue gun. This is a little long, so I'm gonna trim the top to make a ladder to hold our extra folded blankets. I just placed it in the corner. I took this pillow off of my doll couch, and I'm gonna use it to add just a little more color to the bed. I'm gonna add a brown pillow too. I'm bringing back our printable rug. I'm gonna lay it right here on the floor. I'm using poster putty to hold the corners down. Let's add another pillow. I have these giant craft sticks. I bought them at Walmart. Cut off the rounded ends. Cut popsicle sticks. Glue them underneath. I glued one to each side. Glue the shelf to the wall above the bed. I have some miniature plants from Barbie Flowers on Instagram. She has an Etsy shop named Dolls Flowers. I placed the plants on the shelf and a few on the shelving unit. I crocheted this little rectangle here to give the appearance of a blanket. I placed it on the ladder to add some more texture to the room. I crocheted a smaller square. I cut two squares of a matching fabric, placed the crocheted square in between them so it's sandwiched on the inside. On second thought, I might end up missing that smaller square, so I cut a larger one to make sure it gets sewn inside. Sew around the edge of the smaller square, leaving an opening. I used a sewing machine, but this can totally be done by hand. Trim off the excess, then flip it inside out very carefully. Add fluff, sew the opening closed to make a pillow for the bed. I want to bring a lot of texture into this space. Take a wooden dowel, wooden beads, and sheer ribbon. Measure the wooden dowel to the window, including the frame, and cut it. Glue the beads onto the ends. Place the ribbon over the wooden dowel. So we have two layers. I use glue to secure the top. Glue the pole above the windows. Pull the bottom of the ribbon and glue it to the floor. I use the edge of my scissors to push the ribbon into the glue so I don't get burned. Now I have some soft sheer curtains on the windows. Let's make our little sock ottoman. So I take a sock, turn it inside out, and I place it on my arm. Begin rolling it down. I want to keep the sock as tight as I can, then continue rolling until this side is tight. To prevent the center from sinking in, glue a plastic bottle cap inside the sock. Glue on yarn or twine to make a thin little ottoman. I made two so we can stack them, place it by the bed, and it can be used as a nightstand. I think we're just gonna stack a few books there. I brought the large monstera plant that we made in our 14 easy crafts video back into the room and put it in the corner. I added our snake plant. Let's add some LED lights. I hide the battery pack in the corner behind the blankets, and I taped the lights to the wall. Cut foam board into rectangles. Glue coffee stirrers on the sides or skinny sticks. I found a picture of some line art that I liked, and I really lightly sketched it on top, then go over it with a marker. I am trying to do really smooth lines here. Not as smooth as I would like, but I think you can tell that's a light bulb. Place it on the wall. Let's bring back in our square box shelves. I glued one to the wall and added some artificial plants hanging down. I put more line art on this wall. I take the mirror out of an OMG box and carefully cut it out and place it on the wall above the storage unit. Ah, now my line art painting doesn't look right. So we're gonna move it to this wall. Take an old earring, loop yarn or string onto it. I covered the clasp, lay it flat, and trim the bottom. Then hang it on the wall. I just added a string onto the earring and taped it onto the top. Let's bring our basket of yoga mats back in because, you know, I gotta work out. Completing our boho chic inspired room. I like this. It looks comfy, it looks cozy. We have lots of plants, a little lighting because it looks awesome in photos. We reused a lot of the same furniture pieces, but ended up with a completely different look. And now, Mini Toya has a place where she can go and chillax. I should add the guitar from Tiny Frock Shop. It makes a nice little detail in that empty corner because, you know, it's all in the details. I am loving this boho chic type of look.
I have saved so many photos like this on Pinterest.
And I hope I can actually do this in real life. So, wish me luck. Thank you for joining us while we decorated our room with a boho chic kind of feel. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to ring the bell and follow us on Instagram at MyFroggyStuff and the Frog Vlog. And we will see you next time. Bye!